Hey guys, so what's up? I know I haven't been filming for a while. This is gonna be a ramble rant video, so if you don't wanna know about my life, you can click away, that's fine. So I'm really sorry that I haven't been able to film lately. It's just a lot of stress right now. Between school and work, and just having no time, having a lot of stress. Work is a hectic bombshell. I have so many people have quit and are about to leave, and we're about to reach our busy season, and so many people need to be hired, and it's a mess, honestly. It's a huge mess right now. And I'm trying to leave, I'm trying to get a new job, and I'm trying my best to stay positive, which doesn't happen very often. I've had multiple breakdowns just in the past 2 months. So I'm doing the best that I can. I'm trying. I really am. It's just, let's be real. I just don't have the time to do anything. I've been really wanting to film, and lately, in the one time that I possibly somewhat have a little bit tiny to film, something happened. And in my last video, I mentioned that I couldn't talk. I'm pretty sure you guys thought it was like a no talking video. I actually couldn't talk. So I'm doing the best that I can with what I have. I'm trying to stay positive. So if you guys have any ideas that help with trying to stay positive and not make me want to lose my mind or kill somebody, that would be amazing, because I'm very close, very, very close to just, I'm done with the bullshit. I really am. I'm done with my manager, I'm done with this girl at work, I'm done with quite a few things right now that I just feel like I don't need to deal with. I don't need the negativity. I can't hear negativity. I just don't. I'm stuck in a really hard place right now, because aside from work, school will always be stressful. Like, that is just a fact. School will always be stressful. There will be no part of me that's not stressed about school, mainly because, for those who don't know, I'm studying marine biology and I want to be a shark expert. I want to study sharks. However, marine biology is nothing but math and science, my two absolute worst subjects that I just can't comprehend. I truly just don't understand. It's not a matter of me just not wanting to do the work. I just truly don't understand it. Like, there's nothing in my brain that clicks that connects anything in math. Just because there's no why factor to it. You just do the formula. But most of the things that you have to do, like algebra, when will you ever use half of those things in your life? When will somebody ever present me with a problem that's x squared minus 2x plus 3 and tell me to factor it? I don't think that I will need that in my life. But just some things really I can't understand. It just doesn't click well with me in my head, and it's nothing but math and science all the way. And I want to get my doctorate's degree, so it's just going to be another 12 years of absolute hell for me, honestly. But I'm trying, and I will get there. But aside from those two, honestly, I'm actually pretty happier. I'm happier than I've ever been, honestly. I have someone who's truly amazing and so optimistic, and I'm working on projects. I'm working on music. And I'm working on a few projects for my boyfriend, so it's like I'm really excited to get these done. I'm really excited to just have some fun. I have discovered rapping, and I don't mean discovered as in like I made it happen. I've just, in the past years, I've always wanted to write songs, but I can't do it. Also, love songs. I don't write love. I normally, if I write a story, it's going to be about death or murder or something awful. So trying to write a love song has always been hard for me. And those are really the only songs I can think of. I can write breakup songs in like a heartbeat, so it is what it is. But I recently got into rapping. Yes. No, I'm not gonna actually like be a rapper. That's not what I plan on doing with my life. I'm not gonna like be like, what is it, Lil Yeezy? I don't know. Lil Pump, is that his name? Something like that? I don't know. I'm not gonna be like them. I'm not gonna be like 6ix9ine. I'm not gonna be like none of that. I'm not gonna actually be a rapper. But I do have a friend who produces music and stuff like that, who's actually gonna help me produce a couple songs just for the fun of it, because why not? So I'm honestly really excited about that. My raps are really fun, and it's not about bitches and hoes. It's really funny, stupid stuff. It's supposed to be a, like, just a great beat and stuff. It's great. I love it. I'm constantly writing them, so maybe eventually I'll get something out. Probably not, but you never know. That would be exciting. I don't know if my boyfriend watches my channel, so I'm not gonna say anything about his projects just because. But I am excited for those to get done. That's honestly really it. I can't go too into detail about work just because I still work there. But trust me, when I get out of work, I will give you guys all the tea that you need. Not really. It's mainly just my boss. The job is fine. The work is fine. The owner is a really nice guy. He's such a family person. He's lovely, honestly. But my manager is really the only one that just makes me want to stab somebody. Him and another girl at work. She's a new hire, and she's very rude. I've been trying to stay calm, keep my mouth shut. But like I said earlier, I'm just really not gonna deal with the bullshit because I don't need to be dealing with the bullshit. I'm too young to be as stressed as I am. I'm really too young for that. Like, my mindset is like, I should have a car by now and I should be working like towards a house and stuff. Like, no. Those things take time. Like, it's okay. It is completely okay to not have those things right now. That is fine. So, I'm doing the best with what I have. I'm trying to make things easier for me. I'm trying to save up money. Let's see. We have a dog. I don't know if you guys know this, but we have a dog. He's an Australian Shepherd. He's a pain in the ass. He's a jerk. His name is Loki. It was, I think, between like Loki and Chance or Charles or something. And I said, no, we are not giving our dog a fuckboy name. This is not how that's gonna work. So we stayed on Loki, which makes a lot of sense because he's very mischievous. He's a jerk, truly. He's really cute though, but he's still a jerk. He's actually in doggy prison right now, so time out. And then oh, I don't know if you guys know this, but I have another tattoo. I got it for my birthday, which is back in April, but I know that when I've been filming, I've been keeping it covered. I know that my videos it's covered. I know that I haven't posted anything on my Instagram or anything like that, just because I don't want to make any promises that I've made before and I haven't followed through, so I'm done saying that I'm going to be doing something when I don't know. Just honestly. So, yeah, but I do have a new tattoo. Well, it's not really new, but it's a lifeline and it says family on it. Sorry, my arm's like all sideways. Yeah. So it looks like, you probably can't really see it, But yep, it's a lifeline. It has the word family on it. It's a matching tattoo that my mom, my stepdad, my uncle, a few family friends are supposed to be getting as well. None of them have got it yet, so I'm still not sure how I feel about the tattoo. It's not a tattoo that I would get on my own. It's a matching tattoo, so I feel like I won't like it until they get theirs, just because it's not something that I planned on being on my skin unless somebody else was matching with me, if that makes sense. So I don't really know how to feel about it. Most of the time I forget it, just having it on my skin. It's like this one that I have, I just don't see it, so I don't really care about it. I told my dad I promised I would never get another tattoo, which was a lie because I totally forgot that I was going to get my memorial tattoos. So those might be my only tattoos, but after this one on my arm, it was so painful. It was so much more painful than one on my collarbone. So much more painful. And I have to get it redone, but I'm not even going to bother with that. But yeah. All the tattoos that I planned, I was like, nope, I don't want them anymore, I don't want to deal with it, I don't want the pain, none of it, because I'm still getting used to looking at them, because I was so used to not having anything on my skin, and my skin was, in my opinion, I like the way I looked without tattoos. Now that I have them, I'm not really sure how I feel about them. They don't go away, so gotta deal with it. But it's weird because both my memorial tattoos are gonna be on my back. So that's gonna be painful. And then I was gonna have one on my hip, but I was like, it's a fandom tattoo, but I was like, you know what? I don't need that tattoo, so I'm not gonna get it because that's just gonna be really painful and I don't have to go through it, so I'm not. But I wanna get a matching tattoo with my sister, but she's 13 right now, so I have a long time to wait. Maybe I'll want it then, probably not, but I was doing a shark sticker book last night that I wanted to record, but I didn't have any way to record it, so it just wasn't going to happen. But I want to get, like, a shark type tattoo. I don't know. I'm not sure. So my coworker has a heart right here, like, right here under her collarbone. So I'm not getting, like, a fin or something stupid like that. I don't know. Like a shark fin. Let's see. Oh, my other uncle. I have two uncles that are going to get this because he and I are supposed to get a matching tattoo here, but after my arm, I knew I could not survive a tattoo here, so he's just going to get that matching tattoo right there. It's going to be part of his sleeve. And then, let's see. I want to get a tattoo on my thigh, but I feel like I'm too skinny for that. And it's not gonna look good. But I do want a tattoo on my thigh, and I don't know why, but it's been happening recently. But that one, my thigh, was what I had planned for it. I probably might not even want it in like years because I want it to be a family tattoo, my family tattoo. So, because the names that I would put on my body are the people that passed away and my children. So I was thinking about getting something with my children's names on it, and then this girl came in, I think it was on her arm, yeah, and it was a tree, but it was a watercolor tree, and it looked bomb as hell. It was a tree, and then all the leaves are like watercolors, and in the roots of the trees was the husband's name and her name, which I think the husband passed away. Husband's name and her name, and then in the branches was her children's name, but it looked like a tree, but if you looked close enough, it had all the names in it, and I was like, that's bomb. So, I'm not gonna get that exact thing, but something similar. I wanted to do a tree and have my children's names in it. Maybe my husband's name, depending. It depends. If he was passed away, then I would, but if he was still alive, I wouldn't. Not saying that I want him to pass away, because I don't. Rip future husband. But just in general, I don't feel comfortable putting live people's names on my body. So I would put my children's name on my body because that's just one of those things that aren't going to go away. I know some people's children things happen and they go away, but that's just one of those things. Like, I will always have my children. And I feel like if I had abortions, not, whoa, okay, rewind. That was not at all the word that I was going to say. What is that one word? Not abortion. It's not an abortion because I would not get an abortion. Oh, when you lose the baby. I don't know what the word's called. I have to Google it. I know you probably are, like, telling me the word. And y'all probably are like, what? It's a word. Miscarriage. Okay, miscarriage and abortions aren't even close to, like, the same thing. I'm so sorry. Not abortion, because I would never get an abortion. Miscarriage. I would count miscarriages. If I had a miscarriage, I would still put the baby's name on my leg. So, wow, that was insane. I'm so sorry. I would not get an abortion. That's a no-no. That is a no-no. For me, at least. Like, I'm not hating on anybody to have abortions. I'm just saying I would never get one, and I'm, like, really shocked that that word came out of my mouth, so I'm sorry. Miscarriage. If I were to have a miscarriage, that would also be part of my tattoo. So, I don't know. I just don't feel like I want to mark my body anymore, if that makes sense. Like, any of you guys that have tattoos, do you feel the same way? Like, you don't regret the tattoo, but you just wish that you maybe would have waited a little bit. Because, like, I don't regret this one. I just don't see it. So maybe that's why I don't regret it. But this one's just, eh. Maybe if it looked a little bit better. After I got it, I went to the beach. So it has a bunch of salt water and sun, so it's a little faded. So I'd probably get it redone just because I fucked it up. Honestly, but I don't know, I kind of just liked not having anything there. It looks nice, but this tattoo right here has proven to be very useful, so. Oh, I'm still stuck on that abortion thing that really got me shook. But that's kind of what's been going on in my life. The only thing I could think of would be talking about my boyfriend, but I know none of y'all care about that, so. Also, I want to apologize to you guys, because sometimes in the past, I treat this channel as a regular YouTube channel, and I know that it's not. It's an ASMR channel, so I would, for example, when I reached 600 subscribers, me and my ex, of course my boyfriend at the time, we're going to do a Q&A video. Kept saying it over and over, and it never happened. So I apologize for being that person. If I could edit those parts out of my videos, I would, but I can't. So I am sorry for being that type of person. I won't do that again, I can promise you that much. But if you want me to do a Q&A video, just because I do have over 600 subscribers, I can. You can ask me questions on my YouTube channel, my Instagram, the Snapchat that I have. You can ask me on any of those. You can ask me anything you want, but just because you're asking anything doesn't mean I'll answer it. So ask me anything that you want. I'll answer them to the best of my ability, and I'll make a video about it. So if you guys have any questions about work or school or what I like to eat in the morning, anything like that, I'm down. So peace out, loves, and I'll see you next time.